Hello and welcome to my tutorial for mounting source mods on Garry's mod. It's a fairly simple process. In this example, we're going to be mounting this mod here, Resident Evil 2 Source. Just go to C, Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Garry's Mod, Config. And you'll see a file by the name of mount.cfg. Open this and it'll look something like this. Now go to C, Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Source Mods, and get the name of the folder of the mod you want to mount. It has to be exact or it may not work. Now type this line above the bottom bracket, replacing the last part with the appropriate mod folder name. This first part can be whatever you want it to be. Also, if you want to mount Half-Life 2 content via Source SDK 2013 single player, you can do the same like so. This is useful if you don't have any of the Half-Life 2 games, or if you don't want to keep them installed at all times. This will give you pretty much all the content for Half-Life 2 and its episodes, except for the maps. When you're done editing the config file, save and exit. Now launch Garry's mod. The mod's maps should be under the other tab when you're browsing the maps. And that should be it. The mod you mounted should be in working order, minus any crazy custom stuff, such as custom NPCs or other entities. Unfortunately, this doesn't seem to work with soundscapes, either because of a glitch, or it doesn't mount the soundscape script files from the mod's directory. I'll give you an example right now. Here's the mod. And here's Garry's mod. Yeah, tough luck. Anyways, have fun with your newly imported mod shenanigans. Also, please excuse my terrible mic quality. This camera/mic is of caveman quality.